Welcome to Lesson 3B, Working with Strings. We've already spent some time working with lists, which are sequences of anything at all inside Python. We're going to work with strings in this lesson, which are sequences of just individual characters in Python. There's some things that are going to be the same as lists and some things which are unique to strings. So let's get going. The first thing we're going to notice about strings, since they're sequences like lists, is that we can use the same slicing notation to access parts of a string the same way we can to slice lists. So let's illustrate this with a few examples. I'm going to set up a string variable that I'm calling s that contains the characters in the quick brown fox. So I can do things like I can with any sequence. I can say, what's the length of s? It'll come back with, there are 19 characters. Now remember, that means those characters are numbered 0, 1, 2, 3, all the way up to 18, or I could number them starting from the right, negative 1, negative 2, negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, negative 4, and so on, all the way down to negative 19. So how do I slice it? Remember, our slicing notation was inside square brackets, a start, colon, a stop, colon, and a step value. And I can leave any of those out that I want. So S5 colon means start with position 5 and go to the end. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I get from the U in quick through the end of the string. Wick brown fox. If I do S-3, that says start at position negative 3 and go to the end of the string. Here's negative 1, negative 2, negative 3. So that just gives me fox. If I go from 4 to 9, it says start at position 4, go up to, but not including, 9. 0, 1, 2, 3, here's 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, up to, but not including the space after quick, I just get the word quick. And 0, 10, 3, start at 0, go up to, but not including 10, and take every third character. So I'll do, here's 0, the T will be in my answer, skip, skip, here's a blank, that'll be in my answer, skip, skip, here's an I, that will be in my answer, skip, skip, a blank, that will be in my answer, and now I'm up to the end of where I'm going. So I get T blank I blank. And how about if I say, I'm not going to specify the start and the end, but I want you to go down by one. This has the effect of taking all 19 of these characters and just giving them to me in reverse order. So instead of the quick brown fox from left to right, I get the quick brown fox from right to left. Lists had a bunch of methods that you could use, like list variable dot append or dot extend or dot sort. There are a lot of string methods also. If s is the name of a string variable, here's methods you can use with s, meaning the name of your variable dot and then this function name. So I can take any string and say dot capitalize. It will return a copy of s with the first letter capitalized. It doesn't change what's in s. None of these on this page change what's in s. It just says, let's say s was the quick brown fox like we had on the previous page, then s dot capitalize would be the quick brown fox with every letter in uppercase. S dot title returns something in title case, which means the first letter of every word is capitalized and everything else is lowercase. Or I can make everything lowercase or everything uppercase. Watch the second video in this 3B area on the Canvas webpage, and you'll see some examples where we're going to play around with all of these. Here's some more methods. Instead of changing upper to lower case, here's where we can find out what's in a string. If I do s.find and I give it t, a value within the string, and an optional start and an end. If I leave them out, it looks in the whole string. If I put them in, it works just like a slice. It returns the leftmost position of value t, or a negative one if not found. So I can look for, is there an x in the quick brown fox? And if there is, it'll come back and say, yes, it's in position 18, or it's in position 13. Or if there wasn't one in there, it would return a negative one. Index is very similar to find. It returns the leftmost position of the value, but this one generates an error if it's not found, instead of giving me a negative one. I can check and see if a string starts with a particular value. That might be useful if I ask people, enter yes, and I don't care if they put a Y or a yes or a yup or a yeah, as long as it started with a Y. And ends with will return true if the string ends with a particular set of characters that are in the variable x. Again, we'll look at the second video where I'm playing around in idle with these, and I encourage you to do the same thing. Here's a few other miscellaneous methods which are going to be very helpful to us when we do this week's programming assignment, because we're going to get some data that we need to manipulate before we can use it. S.strip returns a copy with leading and trailing white space removed, or the character in chars. Now I can leave chars out and just do s.strip, but if I wanted to get rid of all the x's in something, or all the punctuation, all the periods, all the commas, all the new line characters, I can do that with strip, or with left strip and right strip that only strip at the start and the end. If I leave chars off, it just looks for white space, blanks, tabs, and so on. Split returns a list of strings. I've got a string, I want to split it into a list of strings. Maybe I split every time there's a comma, or every time there's a space. So if I had one, quote, 1, 2, 3, 4, and I split it on commas, it would give me back a list that had quote 1 quote in the first position of the list, then quote 2 quote, quote 3 quote, and so on. We'll definitely be using this in our programming assignment this week. And split lines returns a list of strings that are generated by splitting on line terminators. So if you read the entire text of a book, you could turn it into a list that had one line of the book, then the next line of the book, then the next line of the book, and then step through each of the lines and process them separately, which you might want to split on spaces or punctuation and so on. Okay, we're ready for the next video, in which I'm going to go into idle, create some strings, manipulate them, and I encourage you to get into idle and do exactly the same thing. Play around until you know what happens with strings. See you in the next video.